Hello Internet Land, my name is H, and we're going to be unboxing this key contents, or net contents, portable weather station and alarm clock. Box is kind of crumpled up, I'm not quite sure how that happened. It has a wrist strap. Not quite sure why that would be, this isn't exactly a wristwatch. The lighting's not that good right now. Interesting design. That little like pebble thing to look at it. There's a button there. Let's see, how do we activate this thing? Here's the information. Model F3730621. Takes button batteries, made in China. It's got a little kickstand there. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. That's flimsy. Seriously? I almost broke that off. Alright, well, let's see what else is in here. We do have a manual. Features, displays, hour, minute, year, month, day, and week. It seems like it has a lot of information on there. Now, that's good. Year range of 1900 to 2099. No, well, I would be surprised if this were to last 100 years. Temperature range. Key instruction, mode key at normal time mode. Press mode key to enter into alarm mode. Looking to see if there's any English or anything, because that would be funny. Up key at setting mode. Is this off screen? Oh, here we go. Press up to move up and adjust the digit. Under normal mode, press up to shift between centigrade and Fahrenheit. Which isn't actually too bad. How to use. Please pull out the insulator sheet before operating. Normal time setting. Well, I can probably figure that out, but I don't see an insulator sheet in there, and actually I think this battery compartment seems kind of bulging out of there. Well, I'm going to go get a screwdriver so I can open that up and see what's going on with the batteries there. Alright, got a couple screwdrivers here. Let's see which one fits. There we go, that one seems good. Well, the batteries seem fine. I guess we'll test them out here and see if they're any good. Indeed, they look bad. So, yep. Alright, so we'll go get some new batteries for it. Well, I don't have the right kind of batteries, of course. So we'll see if maybe we can rig it up here. Try that. That doesn't work. Try the other way. No, that does not work. We're getting life out of it. Well, maybe this thing just won't be able to go on there properly until I get the right kind of batteries. Oh man, yeah, that's not really gonna work, is it? Yeah, I'll try it. Just for testing purposes, I'll replace these, you know, when the time comes. But yeah, that works fine. Alright, I'm gonna have to get some better lighting on that so we can set this up. There we go, that's a lot better. Yeah, definitely still kind of stumped as to what's going on with the wrist strap here. Why in the heck would you need that? Anyway, there we got mode set up and down. Let's see here. Mode. And we got the alarm. Okay, that goes between alarm and clock. What does this do? Oh, there's a backlight. Let's see if we can see that better. There we go. Yeah, it looks like that would be the perfect brightness for night. Okay, good. And of course, by default, it's in Celsius mode, so we gotta fix that here. Set. Here we go, 24 hours. Now my camera thinks that this egg thing is a face. No, we don't want 24 hours, we definitely want 12. We go up and down here. Yep, I have to keep looking because I'm not bothering to memorize where these buttons are. Okay, we got PM, it is 6:16. Okay, up. 6:16, there we go. And set again. And now I'm going to set the date. I don't know why I'm cycling all through the months here, because it is January. January 28th. Wednesday, wait a minute. Oh, I didn't set the year yet. Yeah, it's not Wednesday. There we go. Okay, and everything looks to be set. Let's see, up and down. Okay, I put it on F. And that turns the alarm on and off, the down button. So, you know, it's apparently sunny right now. That is actually false because it's raining outside. So I guess we will go ahead and set the alarm here and see what it sounds like. That's not what I meant to do. Look, it has two. Here's the Chinese devices for you. Look at that. That's supposed to be one dot on top and one on the bottom. It's got two double colons on there. Okay, that's funny. Wow, good job. It looks like there's a shadow on there or something casting from the light here, but no. It actually has two colons on there. How about that? Alright, let's see here. We have, there's the speaker. How do we set the alarm here? Mode, I think? Alright, now we're on the alarm, so now we hit set. There we go. Let's set it for 6:20. Set. I didn't set it for 6:20 p.m. Let's try that again. We'll kick out the little stand here and we will wait for 6:20. Back to the regular clock here. And I guess that's also a snooze button. We'll see. We'll test that out when it rings. Oh, look, it flashes the light too. That's rather neat. It's not very loud though. I don't know if that would wake me up unless the room was completely silent. So this does probably count as a snooze. Yeah, that's a snooze. And I don't really have the patience to figure out how many minutes it's going to snooze for, so we'll just go ahead and turn that off. How do we turn that off? Alarm. I don't want the alarm on. There we go, down button. Alright, so that is this unbranded, what's it called here? Portable weather station and alarm clock. And thank you for watching. Oh, here we go. Avon Products. EVON. Canada Incorporated. Or New York NY. From Canada. Whatever. Alright, well, thank you for watching. I will be sure to put this to use somewhere.